Have you ever been asked to do something you weren't sure you could do? This happened to Saint Ambrose. In the year 374, a meeting was called by the people to elect the new bishop of Milan. Ambrose, who was the governor, attended the election for two reasons. He knew there might be disagreements and felt responsible for keeping the peace. Since Ambrose was preparing for baptism, he was also interested in who would be bishop. During the election, fighting broke out. No one could agree on who the bishop should be. Ambrose stood and pleaded for peace in the assembly. During his speech, a voice cried out, "Ambrose for bishop!" Ambrose was shocked. The crowd took up the cry, shouting, "Ambrose for bishop!" Ambrose begged them not to elect him, but he could not silence them. Over the next several months, Ambrose was baptized, ordained, and consecrated bishop. Saint Ambrose, Bishop of Milan, was born in the year 340 into the family of the Roman prefect of Gaul, now France. He was the third child in the family, a sister Marcellina and a brother Satyrus having been born before him. There was a story when he was a child. He was being taken care of by a nurse at the time. One day when the nurse arrived, she was surprised to see a swarm of bees swoop down and rest upon his eyes and lips of the sleeping child. Frightened, she called to some of the members of the household. They came, and Ambrose's father and mother saw the bees enter and leave the mouth of the child without disturbing him. The bees then flew off and were lost in the blazing sun. Ambrose's father exclaimed, "This child is destined for great things." This story of Ambrose symbolizes the future eloquence as the Bishop of Milan and his deeds in the leading of the sheepfold of the church. His father wanted Ambrose to have an administrative career. He was sent to the best school in Rome to study philosophy, theology, and literature. About the year 370, upon completion of his course of study, Ambrose was appointed to the position of governor of the districts of Liguria and Emilia. He continued in this position for 3 years, and he was soon well respected in the community. In the year 374, Auxentius, the Arian bishop of Mediolanum, died. This led to complications between the Orthodox and the Arians, since each side wanted to have its own bishop. Ambrose, as the chief city official, went to the church to resolve the dispute. While he was speaking to the crowd, suddenly someone cried out, "Ambrose for bishop!" The people took up this chant. Ambrose, who at this time was still a catechumen, considered himself unworthy and tried to refuse. He disparaged himself and even tried to flee from the gathering. The matter went ultimately before the emperor Valentinian the Elder, whose orders Ambrose dared not disobey. He gave up all of his worldly belongings, agreed to be baptized and ordained, and devoted his talents to the service of the church. Ambrose's asceticism and generosity increased his popularity. During his time as bishop, he experienced many fierce, bitter struggles in his efforts to eradicate the heresy of Arianism, which denied the divinity of Christ. Saint Ambrose came late to the study of theology, but his scholarly training enabled him to master it quickly. He used all of this while preaching. His abilities impressed Augustine of Hippo, who previously thought poorly of Christian preachers. After meeting Ambrose, Augustine re-evaluated himself and was forever changed. In 387, Ambrose baptized Augustine, who he had a great influence on. Saint Monica, Augustine's mother, loved Ambrose as an angel of God who uprooted her son from his former ways and led him to his convictions of Christ. Ambrose had many churches built and enriched them with relics. He preached and instructed with wonderful eloquence. The poor, the imprisoned, widows, orphans, and the unfortunate won his time and attention. The pen of Ambrose was as eloquent as his tongue. His writings are voluminous, and those regarding religious doctrine are still constantly quoted and appealed to as proof of Christian teaching. Ambrose's career as bishop had three important aspects: the quality of his thought as a Christian intellectual, his role in the final phase of the Arian controversy, and his impact upon the relations between church and empire. Ambrose was an advocate of simplicity. He gave a share of his family's money to the poor and encouraged others to do so. He took a firm stance in controversial matters of church and state. When conflicts arose with the ruling family, Ambrose told the people, "The emperor is in the church, not above it." On more than one occasion, Empress Justina sent soldiers to force Ambrose to go along with her wishes. Ambrose had to defend his cathedral against attack, but the people stood by their bishop, and the army had to back down. Later, Emperor Theodosius, to get revenge for the murder of several officers, had a town of 7,000 people destroyed. Ambrose warned Theodosius that he would be excommunicated if he did not do public penance. People were astounded that Ambrose would do this. Later, they were speechless when Theodosius knelt at Ambrose's feet, humbly accepting forgiveness. Theodosius reconciled himself with the church and the bishop, who attended to the emperor on his deathbed. The fame of Bishop Ambrose and his actions attracted to him many followers from other lands. From far away Persia, learned men came to him to ask him questions and absorb his wisdom. The saint combined strictness with an uncommon kindliness. Granted a gift of wonder-working, he healed many from sickness. One time at Florence, while staying at the house of Decentus, he resurrected a dead boy. Ambrose was generous to the poor. He considered them not a group of outsiders, but rather those of the united people. To him, giving to the poor was just a repayment of God's resources, which were intended for everyone equally. Ambrose is credited with advising Augustine of Hippo to follow local liturgical customs. "When I am at Rome, I fast on a Saturday. When I am at Milan, I do not. Follow the custom of the church where you are," he stated. This advice remains today and is translated in English as the saying, "When in Rome, do as the Romans do." Ambrose led an active life and died at age 57 in 397. Saint Ambrose of Milan was known for being a doctor of the church, Ambrose was the first to formulate ideas about church-state relations, which would become the prevalent medieval Christian viewpoint on the matter. His writings remained an important point of reference for the church well into the medieval era and beyond. Saint Ambrose has been named one of the holy fathers of the church, whose teaching all bishops should in every way follow. O God, you give blessed Ambrose to your people as a minister of eternal salvation. Grant, we pray you, that as on earth he was a teacher of supernatural life, so we may deserve to have him as our intercessor in heaven. Amen.